WildTalkRadio.com.
Theme song!
This is the Firefly Funhouse! And I want to introduce you to some very special friends that I met along the way.
Hey, this is Adam Copeland, a.k.a. the Rated R Superstar.
Hey guys, this is Renee Paquette.
This is Kane from WWE.
This is WWE Superstar Drew McIntyre.
Hello, this is WWE Hall of Famer, the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels.
Hi, this is Bree. And this is Nikki, and we're the Battle Twins.
This is Christopher Daniels, and what I like to do on my off days is listen to the rap, and now you are...
And it is awesome.
Satisfaction is guaranteed.
It's time to experience the award-winning The Rack.
Goodness gracious, great balls of fire.
I love kickball.
I'm back, taking souls and digging holes.
I'm gonna break you, bitch, you hear me?
You can live, but you can't touch.
Ruthless aggression.
With your host.
They've been lying to you. Heroes don't exist. Y'all become addicted to the illusion of what a hero does for you. Have I mentioned that I was once addicted to eating sponges?
Lindsey Ward.
Look at me, woman.
And you can just call me Taker.
Oh my God, it's Taker. Taker, Taker, Taker. Does Taker hate me? Oh my God, it's Taker.
And she was a wicked, wicked child who spat and swore and chewed tobacco.
I like puppets.
Stickers!
And her producer, Sir Rockin.
My little creatures of the night will now experience the magical art of puppetry.
If you smell... Ow! What the game is playing!
Live on the Wild Talk Radio Network.
We're here.
Yowie wowie!
Welcome to The Rack right here on WildTalkRadio.com, brought to you by our friends over at MBG Films. Check them out at YouTube.com/MBG1211. And if you're listening to us over on RackRadioShow.com, WildTalkRadio.com, or directly on Twitch, thank you so much for tuning in. Greatly appreciate it. You're on Twitch and you happen to have a Prime Gaming sub available where you can use it here for free for 30 days. All you have to do is hit the little purple button down at the bottom of the screen and you can subscribe for free. It is that simple. You can also subscribe the regular way, follow the channel, hang out and chat, or listen to the archive. We are happy to have you any way we can get you. I am your host, Lindsey Ward. Joining me, as always, is the ever-faithful producer, slash co-host, slash handyman, Sir Rockin.
We're here. We're live, and it's someone's birthday.
Yes. Thank y'all. Thank you for the nice messages. I appreciate it.
Tweet us at Wild Talk Radio, at Record Show. At Lindsey Ward, come to WildTalkRadio.com, RecordShow.com, or Twitch.tv/WTLive. And holy crap, we've taken the lead.
Everybody pray. Everybody
as we go to halftime. So
diamond hands, hold.
Just hold it right. Just right there. You can end the game right now. It's, you know, a whole nother half, but we were down a lot. No jinxing. I will hurt people.
Yes, please don't jinx the process. Yeah, don't do that.
No more jinxing. No more.
Wait, do you have a Sixers good luck charm? Because, you know, I know I'm your Eagles luck charm, good luck charm, but do you have like a Sixers one?
No. Everyone roots against me, so it's fine. It's fine. Everyone just kills all my hopes and dreams when it comes to sports, so it's fine. We're not here to talk about that.
What do you mean we kill your hopes and dreams when it comes to sports? I cheered for Philly.
There are other people who just kill it.
Right.
Anyway.
Thanks, Keishi.
Anyway, we're here to talk sport. We're here to talk professional wrestling, sports, entertainment. Because we got news presented, as always, by MBG Films, YouTube.com/MBG1211. And in the back half of the show, we got Backlash. Yes, we're talking about Backlash.
Woo, Backlash! Which emanates live from Lyon, France. Oui, oui.
At 1 p.m. Eastern on Saturday afternoon. Should be fun.
That'll be. I can eat my lunch and watch wrestling. That will be lovely. That will be perfect.
Mm-hmm. And it should be before the Derby's this weekend, right?
Yeah. Derby is Saturday, and it runs. It should run like 6-ish.
Yeah. So if wrestling will be over by then. Yeah.
So
wrestling in a Derby. I mean.
Wrestling into horse racing. What could be more American? I mean, really.
And then, chat, breaking news. This Saturday, game night, we're playing Fortnite.
Now, are we playing Lego or are we playing
We're playing regular Fortnite, so Brent can shing all around the world.
Oh, hell, I'm going to have to dust it off. I haven't opened it in weeks.
So, we're playing Fortnite, so Brent can Star Wars it up.
Woot woot.
But let's get into the news.
That's right. Let's get into the news brought to you by MBG Films, youtube.com/MBG1211. Jumping into the WWE news, we have some exciting re-signings and returns. Eric Rowan is back with the company, so I wonder if he's going to be a part of the mysterious teasers that we've been seeing.
Yeah, so that should be interesting. It's been rumored that he was on his way back once the teaser started. It makes sense. If they're doing this whole Bray Wyatt tribute angle, I guess finishing off the story, closing that chapter, and it makes sense to have him in the fold. You have him and Taylor Bo, whatever you want to call him, for Uncle Howdy. If Alexa is on her way back, I don't know if Braun's going to be in the revival. He is there. But they brought him back in another role. So I think if he was coming back for that, he would have been safe for it.
I mean, it makes sense just because Teardrop. Eric Rowan is the only surviving member of the original Wyatt family. So it makes sense that he will be a part of this. It should be very cool. I think this has been in the works for a while.
Yeah, it has been. They've been planning it for a while. It's just whenever the timing was right. And with the documentary that came out and giving closure to that, right in that manner, and now kind of honoring his legacy and, I don't know, doing a Wyatt 6 or something in that manner. Who knows? We'll see.
I am curious about it. Like, I'm not invested in it yet, but I'm curious to see what they do with it. Just because it's like that story was left unfinished. So it's like, how do you finish it now? What was going to be the story that they were going to tell? Because you kind of hear things about, well, at some point they were planning like the Cody versus Bray feud. And it's like, God, I wish we had gotten that because there's so much history there, but we never got it for obvious reasons. So it would just be it will be interesting to watch.
Yeah.
And bring back the puppets. The rabbit. Bring back the rabbit. Resurrect the rabbit. Who's sitting behind me right now? Another exciting news. Drew McIntyre re-signed with WWE as well. Seems that his issues with or waiting, I guess the hold is over.
Yeah. He's the first of many to re-sign with the company. He got a 3-year deal, I think, something like that.
But it was cool how they did it because they had The Rock like video him re-signing, and The Rock announced it for him. Although The Rock's kind of in hot water right now.
Yeah, but that, you know, that's late to the news.
But only by 5 hours. So it's
only by 5 hours.
Should we get in a fist fight or something, like a screaming match?
Then he pees in a bottle too. People didn't know.
Okay, I'm sorry, that's gross. I read that. And it's not the pee in the bottle part. Can I just go off on this for a second?
Yeah.
It's not the pee in the bottle part. Like, I get that. I understand that. I even respect it a little bit because he's trying to like not just pee everywhere, right? But then he hands the bottle to like his assistant, and he expects his assistant to get rid of it for him. To just dispose of his pee. Like, I'm sorry. You better be paying me an ass load of money to do that. Because there's just no way. There's just no way. No. No, that is beyond my job description. That is outside of the realm of things that I would be willing to do for a person. Unless they're paying me a lot of money.
And the best part was, like, it was a fancy bottle of water, too.
Something
like that.
Like a glass bottle too, I think.
Yeah.
It's not one of the cheap plastic bottles, it's like the expensive water.
They had to add that detail into the story. I found that funny. But no, so
well, you can't have The Rock peeing into a Kirkland bottle. Like, I mean, come on.
Yeah. So Drew got the contract, he got a sword.
Yeah, he gets to keep the sword.
Yeah, so.
Which I guess makes sense because Vince doesn't really need it anymore.
No, no, no. Fragile Vince doesn't need it anymore.
Have you heard them talking about like Vince's office in WWE? No. Like in the headquarters? It's probably still there.
Yeah, it's just untouched.
It's untouched, but they said it's like really eerie in there. Because like it's all his, well, all his stuff is still in there and like everything's still there, but like just nobody's there. So it's like really kind of creepy and eerie and weird in there.
At least it's a new office, it's not the old office, because that would be even creepier. Anyway.
I think the old office is still there too, like still intact too. I don't think they got, because they didn't sell the building, right? I think they still own it.
Maybe.
So I imagine the old office is like still there in some capacity.
It could be.
The giant dude, I wonder if they moved the giant T-Rex head.
Because you just leave it alone until that, you know, you want to get rid of it. Oh, I think all of his personal possessions are out of it. I think whatever artwork is there is just artwork until they fill the office.
The question is are they going to officially replace, in quotations, his position? And does the person that replaces him need that office? Because I'm, you know, Hunter obviously has his own, Nick Khan obviously has his own. So it's the question of if somebody replaces Vince, because I think his final title was he was the executive chairman of the board.
Yeah, and I bet from whatever we hear about his office, I bet it's cleared now. I think in the last couple months it's probably been taken apart, because it's probably an old story that came out about it. Once
probably,
he,
yeah.
Back in probably January when everything came out, his office probably been shut off and cleared, and someone else is using it now.
Maybe Nick Khan.
Maybe.
Because I'm sure it was a very nice office.
Probably.
Anyway, SummerSlam tickets go on sale on May 9th at 10 a.m. And the pre-sale is May 7th, so get your tickets. Ding!
SummerSlam in Cleveland. It's going to be a thing. Hopefully it sells out.
I hope it sells out. I mean, that would be kind of cool for them.
Yeah.
And last but not least, at least for WWE, it was announced, or I guess put out there. I shouldn't say announced, but like basically somebody, maybe Scripps himself, put it out
there. He did.
There
that, he did. He put out a video.
That WWE is not going to be renewing his contract, that it's up in June, and then he's going to go ahead and leave the company.
No, it's up now. He's free in on June 1st.
Oh, okay. So he's leaving.
Yeah, yeah. His contract was up at the beginning of last month, beginning of this month, and he's out as a free agent in 30 days, so June 1st.
I mean, you hate it for him, but the gimmick they had him in, at least on the final run, didn't make a lot of sense.
No, I mean, they tried, but sometimes you just, he didn't, like, he did flashy, he was very athletic, but they have a lot of it, and sometimes you just don't, sometimes things just doesn't work out, and it didn't work out for him. They tried different roles with him, and it just didn't play off. Reggie worked originally.
Yeah, Reggie worked really, really well.
But then when the stuff with Carmella ended, it kind of fizzled and faded away. It happens. So. And then the 24/7 stuff, he was good, he had a run. You can't get more. Sometimes you only get the one run, and he got his. He may.
I mean, there's nothing wrong with that.
Honestly, a TNA would be a good spot for him.
Yeah, it would, with the X Division. Yeah, that'd be good.
Not even X Division. It's, they give you more creative freedom as a character to just sort of do things. So if he wants to play that role,
yeah, nothing wrong with that.
They give you more freedom to be a all-around performer. Because if you're in Ring of Honor or just on Rampage, you don't get that whole character development thing, which he's better at. So, we'll see.
We'll see. And he may be joining NWA or former NWA Women's Champion Camille as she is signed with AEW.
Yeah, that's the news. She's been a free agent for a while.
How tall is she?
I don't know.
Because I saw like a picture of her in like heels, and they basically did the tall girl, short girl meme.
Mm-hmm.
And like legit the other girl's head like came up to her boobs.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, god damn, how tall is she?
5'10". So there you go. 5'10".
There you go. All right. So congratulations to her and AEW. Hope it works out. As my voice decides to be like, no, I don't want to work. So AEW has also hired Jeremy Flynn as their new senior marketing director of live events.
He was part of the Professional Bull Riding Association or something. PBR. Mm-hmm. He held that role there. So now he's coming over to AEW to work in that role.
This is a curious thing for me, because this is the first big marketing move they've made in quite a while. And I hope this means that they realize that they need to improve their marketing, especially for their live events, because I've heard a lot of people say, I didn't even know they were in town.
You mean the job Jeff Jarrett was doing and trying to book live events, and now they've hired two people in that whole category to kind of do a professional job with it? Not to say Jeff wasn't doing it, but he has there's a difference between having the wrestling promoter side of promoting events to someone who's actively knows how to do it in 2024 as a sporting event and stuff like that. So that's been something that they needed to fix, and them announcing a schedule and now having with the new person in charge of booking their events, and now this guy coming in to help promote them and hopefully help fill the buildings and get them on, just get the word out.
Get them back on
track. Yeah, because they need some help trying to book buildings and what works for them. And I think they're figuring it all out. But
well, I think it was they hired Jeff because Jeff could kind of maybe get them into some bigger buildings, but the bigger buildings have not been working out. And so it could be that they're trying to get back into smaller venues again, or at least different venues in different cities. Which a PBR connection would be very good for.
Yeah.
This is a great move for them. I hope they continue to do stuff like this because they need to. They really, really, really need to. The one thing that they have absolutely suffered from is their marketing, both digitally, on TV, and just for their shows. Like, in the beginning, when AEW first debuted, the marketing was everywhere. You were getting ads, you were getting commercials, you were getting pre-roll, you were getting all kinds of things. Like, they had a whole marketing strategy for AEW to get it out there. And then it just kind of stopped. And I don't know whether I fell out of the algorithm or what happened, but they just stopped doing their marketing pretty much altogether. And I rarely, if ever, see it. Like, the most promotion I see is from the AEW Twitter. Like, that's it. Or Tony or something. So the fact that they're making marketing moves is a good thing. So keep doing it.
Yeah, exactly. Keep doing it.
Lane Brents?
Let's do the injury roundup.
Bones breaking. Backs cracking. Shoulder snapping. It's this week's injury roundup.
All righty. Powerhouse Hobbs is out with an injury.
# blame Brent.
He's expected to be out long term. They did not disclose what it is. I believe it's a lower body injury, I think. I could be wrong. I didn't see the match he got hurt in. But it was against Mox last week. I think it was lower body. Brent will could correct me if not. But
I heard it was pretty nasty.
Maybe. I didn't see it. So maybe Brent can fill us in. We'll see. And then there's the other one.
Julia Hart is out with a shoulder injury.
# blame Brent.
Yeah, she came in. She's been dealing with shoulder problems, and I think she's going to probably get it looked at and kind of be out for a bit. That's why she dropped the title. And that knee injury for Hobbs. Yeah, that's what I thought. It's for Julia. Like, Hobbs is one story, and he'll bounce back. Julia Hart had a lot of momentum, and she was in the big angle with Mercedes. And they kind of had a, you know, transition out of that with her. So kind of sucks for her. She's been on a roll. But injuries have played a part in the last few months that kind of derailed her title reign.
Yeah.
Where she was less prominent in the role.
So I hate that for her. I hope she can recover and come back.
Yep.
But with that, I think we're going to go to break.
Sounds like a good plan to me.
So when we come back, we are going to be talking all about WWE Backlash, which is going to be live this Saturday from Lyon, France. So you don't want to miss it. You're listening to The Rock right here on WildTalkRadio.com, and we will be right back.
Pieces fall into pieces. Fight.
Are you following us on twitch.tv/WTR live? Do you have Amazon Prime? If so, you can link it to your Twitch account and subscribe to our Twitch channel for free with Twitch Prime. It's the easiest way to help support us for free.
Every Sunday night, the evolution continues with Wrestle Talk Radio, giving you all the latest happenings in sports entertainment. With the intern, the producer, the original Tim Stein, and sometimes, a K-Sheep. It's WTR Sunday night, 10 p.m. Eastern, 8 p.m. Mountain, only on the Wild Talk Radio Network. This just into the CB Radio news desk. Sources have confirmed that CB Radio will be live Saturday nights at 11:30 p.m. Eastern.
Wasn't this confirmed last year?
Yes.
Then how is this breaking news?
No one said it was breaking news. We here at the CB Radio news desk are just confirming what has already been confirmed.
To confirm, you are just confirming that CB Radio is live Saturday nights at 11:30 p.m. Eastern.
Confirmed. We would like to remind you. Always trust the source that confirms that CB Radio is live Saturday nights at 11:30 p.m. Eastern.
Confirmed.
Confirmed.
Like what you hear? Subscribe to The Rack on Apple Podcasts. Just search for The Rack Radio Show. And while you're there, leave us a review and tell us your thoughts on your favorite show on a Thursday night.
Every Monday night, once Monday Night Raw ends, the Raw post-show goes live.
You want to hear a story? Get the hell yeah!
Join Lindsey and Sir Rockin as they give their opinions on what they liked.
What?
What they didn't like.
What?
And what left them completely confused.
What?
It's the Raw post-show.
What?
Monday nights.
What?
11 p.m. Eastern.
What?
Live on the Wild Talk Radio Network.
And that's the bottom line. Go Stone Cold Simpson.
Did you know that you can use support a creator code ROCKSOCK in the Fortnite item shop? That's ROCKNSOCK in the Fortnite item shop. Hashtag ad because we are a hashtag epic partner.
Hello, this is WWE Hall of Famer, the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels, and you're listening to Rack Radio.
Welcome back to The Rack right here on WildTalkRadio.com, brought to you by our friends over at MBG Films. Check them out, youtube.com/MBG1211. And if you're listening to us over on RackRadioShow.com, WildTalkRadio.com, or directly on Twitch, thank you so much for tuning in. We greatly appreciate it. If you're on Twitch and you happen to have a Prime Gaming sub available, well, you can use it here for free for 30 days. All you have to do is hit the little purple button down the bottom of the screen and you can subscribe for free. It is that simple. You can also subscribe the regular way, follow the channel, hang out and chat, or listen to the archive. We are happy to have you any way we can get you. And with that, we are talking about Le Backlash from
Le
France.
Backlash.
Oui, oui.
France. This Saturday. France. 1 p.m. Eastern, 10 p.m. on the West Coast. Google time zones for time and availability. You're neck of the woods. I think it was like a 5 p.m. local time or something.
Something
in
like
France.
That, yeah.
Something to make it work. Maybe a little bit later. Who knows? No, it would be... They're, what, 5 hours away? 6 hours away from the East Coast?
Six.
So seven would be seven local. The five is the press conference. That's right. Tomorrow. Five local, I think. Anyway, that's a story for a different day. We're here to talk Backlash. But yeah, should be a fun show. Let's talk about some of the matches.
So we have five matches on the card.
Which is pretty standard.
They've been sticking to about 5 to 7, with the exception of WrestleMania.
Yeah, WrestleMania is different. But for these regular premium live events, 5 to 6 matches. And they're there two nights with SmackDown. So that you're getting pretty good value since they're doing combo tickets for a lot of it. So you're going to see enough people. And you got a pretty good mixture of talent because tomorrow there's like tag title match and stuff like that. So that should be fun. And who knows, they may add another match on SmackDown to kind of push it over. Or you may get some appearances because some people say, if you believe the internet, there's a woo in town for whatever reason.
Wait, which woo?
The female one.
Okay.
Yeah, the male one signed with another company. He wouldn't be in town.
That would not stop him.
No, but it would. And then apparently someone saw him at a coffee shop in France, even though you're not supposed to see him. Yeah, so you may see it. Who knows? Or he's just filming, and who knows? Who knows why the man you cannot see would be in town?
Maybe it's weird that they saw him.
I know, it's very weird. Very difficult. Maybe he's there to say France needs WrestleMania, like he was there last year when London needed one. Anyway, who knows? Let's talk some matches.
All right, let's talk some matches. This is post-draft. All the rosters are settled. Everybody's good to go. So up first, we have RKO, Randy and Kevin Owens, taking on I'm going to call them the new bloodline, because it's not the old bloodline. It's the new bloodline, in Solo Sikoa and Tama Tonga.
They've done a hell of a job putting Tama Tonga over for the 3 weeks, 4 weeks he's been with the company.
They made him look like a boss, man.
All right, before we get into all that, go ahead, continue.
The car accident. Just the car accident. The way they did that was really well done.
Yeah, Owen showing up bloody, stumbling around from the beatdown, and then showing a car accident. Yeah, that was well done. I need to address the internet for something. So,
okay.
The interwebs in the news headlines have gone, Solo Sikoa has lost 42 matches in a row. I need to tell the internet, wins and losses on house shows don't mean anything.
It doesn't happen on TV. It doesn't count. Unless they show it on TV, and then it counts.
Has Solo lost a couple of matches on television? Yes. Was he working house shows as the top heel for the past 6 months? Yes. And baby faces, 99% of the time in the main event, always end up winning. And usually, and if the heel is the champion, babyface usually wins by disqualification. Because on a house show, you send the people home happy. So calling Solo losing 40-something matches in a row, not a real thing. Has he lost a few on television? Yes. Have they been to main eventers? Yes. So stop with those headlines. Anyway, back to the presentation of the new bloodline. Solo taking over, Paul Heyman scared shitless, them getting rid of Jimmy has been done really well. Which means there's no way they should lose on Saturday.
No. As much as I love Kevin and Randy, they can eat the loss easily and be completely fine, because they can always come back. But you need, especially because you are establishing Solo as the new leader, you're having Tama be his second, and potentially there's a third on the way, possibly a fourth. You need to make them as just badass as possible, especially considering the failure at WrestleMania, which is Roman losing the title and the loss of the status that they now have to fight to get that position back. And you have Solo and Tama and the people that eventually will join them fighting for that, to get to Cody, to get to that title, to get to back to the top. And you're going to have them be just absolutely completely vicious, because Solo does not have the, I'm going to say, privilege that Roman had. Roman had the status when he came back to walk out mid-match and be like, all right, I'm ready to fight now, because he was already a top star. Solo is a star, but he's still being built. He's still on the rise. So he doesn't have that privilege of being able to name the time and the place of where he's going to call his shot. He has to take every opportunity he can get to continue to climb, to get back to that title. And he's doing it relatively quickly, which is good. And they're building a strong network around him and Tama and some of the others when eventually they debut. Because I think they signed Jacob Fatu, is that right?
Yeah.
So he will eventually join them, and you'll have the trio, and then you can eventually add others as well if you want. But yeah, for this point and purpose, you need to have Solo and Tama just dominate, and you just need to have them win in relatively spectacular fashion.
Yeah, it's Randy and Kevin. They can lose.
Totally.
It's very simple and easy. A loss does nothing for them.
Can the internet fans stop with the stopwatch shit as well? I mean,
yes.
No. They should, but no, they're not going to.
Oh my god, this show has only X amount of time for a show match. Like, come on. Stop. It's dumb. Find something better to do with your time. Internet. Anyway, so I'm going Bloodline, you're going Bloodline. Wheel?
Wrestler 2.
Bloodline. 8-Ball Bloodline? All signs point to yes. So RKO is going to win.
Oh dear.
Because we all went in one direction.
Dear. The Kabuki Warriors, Asuka and Kairi Sane, taking on Bianca Belair and Jade Cargill. This is for the women's tag team championships.
I mean, it's very obvious that Bianca and Jade are winning.
Oh,
and
yeah.
It should be. They need to be, give the belts to them. Let them appear on both shows. Build star power around them. Damage Control needs to sort of reset. Especially now that they're moving to Raw.
Yeah.
So, can they win the titles back at some point? Yes. Should the title change hands here? Yes. Bianca and Jade are your top, are the right people to hold it. And I hope with Bianca and Jade holding the belts, they have a nice run and you build up these teams to fight them and actually have some pretty good matches. But Jade's not losing this. Unless Bianca turns, there's no way. It's too early for Jade to lose.
If the point and the purpose is to build Jade up to eventually point her at either a Bayley or whomever is the women's champion at that point, either on Raw or SmackDown, depending on what you want to do, the smart thing is to put the tag team titles on her, let her and Bianca have a run, let them be completely dominant, let them just go through people and really control and run the division, and kind of have both Bianca and Jade put, at this point, Becky and Bayley on notice that it's like, hey, we're right here. And with a specific briefcase event coming up, you could have Bianca or Jade take the briefcase. And now you have one of them walking around with the briefcase as a threat, as a very real threat, where it's, yeah, I can cash in at any point, but I'm going to wait. Or they could do it that night. I still feel it would be a little early if they put it on Jade right then and there, but...
No, it's too early to put the singles belt on her. Too early.
But to have her walking around with the Money in the Bank and just being a very dominant tag team champion, that sends a message.
And I think this is a good distraction, a side quest for Bianca and Jade. It gets them out of the main title picture, but they're still champions, and allows them to tell other stories with Bayley and Tiffany and Becky and Liv and whoever else you're going to throw in the mix on Raw. It gives them an opportunity to kind of keep them away from the main titles, but yet still being prominent on television. It's the right move. I'm going Bianca and Jade to take home the belts.
I think it's a good distraction, but it's also good experience for Jade to help continue her growth and help her improve and gain more experience for her, which is ultimately the point. So when they're ready to like basically put that singles title on her, she's good to go. And this will help alleviate some people where she's just not drifting of, oh, she's not doing anything. She hasn't won a title yet. You know, blah, 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 with people complaining. Well, it's here you go. You can put a title on her. She can be dominant with Bianca. And she could look like a badass doing it. So it makes complete sense to do it here. I think the Kabuki Warriors have had their run with it. Put it on somebody fresh. Refresh the damage control and do the thing. So I'm going with Jade and Bianca.
8-Ball Jade and Bianca? Outlook not so good. Okay, so that's going with damage.
Wrestler 1.
Okay, the objects are going with the Kabuki Warriors. Okay.
Interesting. Interesting, interesting, interesting. All right. In a triple threat, speaking of the champion, Bayley is taking on Naomi and Tiffany Stratton for the WWE Women's Championship.
The unpopular idea is to put the belt on Tiffany right here. Tiffany just should be a champion at some point. But the problem is, Bayley just won the belt.
Yeah.
I feel like Tiffy time is coming. I know that on Sunday they talked about her getting the briefcase, and maybe that's what they do down the line. But I think you're going to be at a point here soon that Tiffany needs the belt to cement herself in the top tier of the division. She was a good NXT Women's Champion. She had a great match with the series of matches with Becky last year. And she's kind of been supplanted there. It's like she's upper mid-card main event of the division. But she needs the belt to, like, make her mark. And I think we're very short. We're coming up on a period of time where they could really hitch their wagon onto her and do something. But the problem is Bayley just won it 3 weeks ago at WrestleMania and shouldn't be dropping the belt. That's why Naomi's in this match. Take a fall.
Yeah.
Or cost, or like hit Tiffany and then, or distract Tiffany and then Tiffany eats the pin. But there was a, you know, it took two people to beat Tiffany rather than one. This should be a good match. I really expect a lot of good things from this match. It'll be interesting how the crowd reacts to Tiffany in France. Bailey's usually good overseas with the crowd, so it should make for a fun atmosphere. And the reason I go with Tiffany, I would say Tiffany should get the belt, because heels are better as champions, and babyfaces are better at chasing. And I think Bailey's better at the chase long term, but she needs a few. She needs this belt till SummerSlam, and I think that's when you do the big title change. So I'm gonna go Bailey retains. But go ahead.
By the way, I love the idea on Sunday of the Barbie-fied Money in the Bank briefcase, the bright bubblegum pink diamond encrusted case. I love that idea. Mm-hmm. I would be on board for that. I would probably buy one. We actually have, for the next three matches, three brand new champions that are going to be putting their titles on the line. Bayley deserves a little bit of a run with the title, just because you're reestablishing Bayley as a babyface. So she needs sort of to build her foundation back as a single star, because she was in damage control for so long. You kind of need to reset her. And with Tiffany, I love Tiffany. I love the gimmick. I think what she's doing now works. It resonates. But I think she needs a little more time. I think it's a little early. I think you could build her up, especially if you have her lose here. And she loses because, you know, maybe Bianca and Jay get involved, or because Naomi costs her, or because Bayley costs her. And you put that chip on her shoulder and you have her be like, oh, bitch, no, no, we're not doing this. No. And you continue to build her up and keep her like right on that cusp and right in that title picture. But she has to fight to get there and really go head to head with Bayley, like really challenge Tiffany character-wise. And you can put the Money in the Bank briefcase on her, or you can have her just put her in a regular feud with Bayley, because I think Bayley versus Tiffany, especially face Bayley versus heel Tiffany, would be a very interesting feud.
You could also make Tiffany Queen of the Ring.
You could also make Tiffany Queen of the Ring. She would be absolutely obnoxious with it, and she would own the shit out of it. I would actually be interested to see. The thing is what I would love to see Tiffany do, especially if she does a one-on-one feud with Bayley, is like she mocks Bayley's old gimmick, where she has like the Bayley buddies, but they're like all bright pink, and she comes out with like the side ponytail and the gear and everything, mm-hmm. but it's all like pink. Like, I would love to see all of that just for that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Where she pokes and prods at Bayley, and she mocks Bayley, and she's like, oh, you know, how many tries did it take you to become NXT Women's Champion? How many times did you fail at becoming WWE Women's Champion? How long did it take you to win a title at WrestleMania? You know, how long did it take you to do this, do that, whatever? Because then Tiffany can add it up against her own accomplishments, and you can really have Tiffany rub it in. So as you're building that match to the point that, yes, you get to SummerSlam, and then you give Tiffany the big moment at SummerSlam, but you have Bayley carry that title in the meantime. No offense to Naomi, I'd love to see her win a title, but I just don't think it's here.
It's not here. She's a good asset in the division, just not ready for the belt right now.
Unless they want to pull out a surprise and they have Bianca, Jade, and Naomi all win in one night, which they absolutely could. And I don't think anybody would be really offended by that. But it would just be very odd with Bayley winning the title 3 weeks before.
Yeah.
But they may hotshot the title a little bit because a lot of the titles have been sort of sitting for a long time. You had those long-term champions. They may move the titles around a little bit just for variety.
Yeah. So it could happen, but we'll see. You're going Bayley?
I'm going Bayley.
I'm going Bayley. 8-ball Bayley. It is decidedly so. Wheel.
Wrestler 2.
That's Naomi.
Okay. All right. For the World Heavyweight Championship, we have Damian Priest, aka the bisexual Undertaker, taking on Jey Uso.
This is a big spot for both. Jimmy underperformed at WrestleMania. They blame it on timing. I don't think so. I think it was just the match was just not the way it was. It's just not a match. Brother matches are not the best, and it kind of proved the point at WrestleMania.
It had all the potential to be really, really good. It just didn't happen.
Yeah, this is one of those matches where Damian's in a spot where he's a champion now in a solo capacity, so he has to kind of out there and deliver. He did a year ago with Bad Bunny at Backlash, and hopefully this is an opportunity for the two of them to show out and show up and sort of deliver a really good match. It's very obvious Damian's winning. There's more money in Damian as champion right now than Jay as champion, especially since you're kind of breaking Damian away from the Judgment Day. So I'm going Damian retained in a really good match.
Yeah, I expect this to be very, very good, very entertaining. This is a chance for Damian and Jay, like you said, to show up and show out and put something together. I just, as much as I would love to see Jay climb that mountain and get that title, and I think eventually he will, I don't think this is it. Because again, it's the same thing with Bayley. You just put the title on Damian. You had him do it at WrestleMania where he cashed in the Money in the Bank on Seth, got the title and left, and he did it. Or no, he took it off of Drew. And there's more money in Damian and Drew when they get there versus Jay and Drew. And if you take the title off of Damian right now, it's going to kill the character. It's going to kill him figuratively, not literally.
He needs this win under his belt. First match as champion, he needs it.
Yeah, he needs to win clean. You could probably have Judgment Day get a little involved, but ultimately Damian Witt needs a clean victory, a dominant victory, to establish him as champion, because he is now the face of Raw. So he you is. Have to make him look strong.
Yeah.
So I say Damian wins.
We're going Damian as well. Magic 8-Ball. We'll do flip it up. Yeet 8-Ball. Yeet. Yes to the yeet. Wheel.
Wrestler 1.
That would be the champion, Damian Priest. All right, one more match.
Okay. I don't think there's much discussion on this one, but we're going to discuss it. He's the poster boy. It's all about him. He finished the story, and now he's the champion. Cody Rhodes taking on AJ Styles for the former UWU, now undisputed WWE Championship.
AJ Styles is Kane right now. He's the veteran who gets the first title match. This should be a hell of a match. They both had a lot to prove coming back to WWE and in their runs in WWE, kind of similar path. AJ left TNA to kind of make himself a bigger star to come to WWE, which he did. Cody left WWE, created AEW, went to New Japan, became the bigger star. This is going to be a hell of a main event, but it's Cody winning because he's in the wrestling man feud of he's going to knock them all down for a while before he sinks his teeth into like a real full-fledged story. He's going to defend champion challenger after challenger and challenger. So every month he's going to have someone new. It's not going to be a long-term, it's going to be quick stories for him for a while. AJ's the first. Should be a hell of a match. Cody retains.
Yeah, I'm with Rock on this. There's no reason to take the title off of Cody. You just put it on him. We had the 2-year story to get here. To have him lose it on his first pay-per-view defense, or excuse me, PLE defense, is just kind of foolish and stupid. And no, that's not going to happen. I expect Cody to be a very long-term champion. I'm thinking he goes at least a year with this title.
No. Will he in a year be champion? Yes. Will he get caught along the way? Yes. Because, again, babyface is on the chase. He will take down a few challengers, but someone will step up, knock him off, and he'll have to recapture it a couple months later.
You think so?
Yes. I think that needs, for the drama curve of professional wrestling, yes, it needs to happen. It needs to happen. Because him flatlining and just winning every title defense, you're going to lose interest. You need drama.
Okay. All right, so I'm going Cody. You're going Cody?
I'm going Cody. 8-Ball Cody? It is certain. Wheel?
Wrestler 2.
AJ Styles.
Okay. All right.
That's our show.
That does it for us, y'all. What do you think? You can submit your picks over on Twitter, and where do they go for that?
Twitter.com/WildTalkRadio, Facebook.com/WildTalkRadio Network. But that'll do it for the Rack live right here on Wild Talk Radio Network. Tomorrow night, 10 p.m. Eastern, it is GM Battles with myself and Brent. We're going to continue on our path and booking shows and all that fun stuff. Join us 10 p.m. Eastern. Saturday night, lightsabers and more. And Fortnite Battle Royale, the ultimate Battle Royale experience for WTR Game Night, followed by CB Radio live at 11:30 p.m. Eastern. We have an interesting debate for Star Wars.
For pew-pews?
Something like that. It's going to be an interesting Star Wars debate. It's going to be fun. Someone will hate it. Yes, Star Wars. Because it's May 4th. It's going to be an interesting one. Talk about it. Saturday, 11:30 p.m. Eastern. Sunday night. Not you. The person who has to read the debate will hate it.
Although you may hate it as well. You may hate it as well. But we'll see.
Brent's going to hate it.
Brent's going to suffer.
A lot.
Tune in for Brent suffering.
Uh-huh. Sunday, 10 p.m. Eastern, WTR Sunday, Russell Talk Radio reviews Backlash. Join us as we review the entire thing. Monday, it's Raw Post Show, 11 p.m. Eastern. We'll be back next Thursday night, 10 p.m. Eastern. We'll review Backlash right here, live on the Rack. It's at Wild Talk Radio on Twitter, Facebook.com, is Wild Talk Radio Network. Track Radio shows on all social media platforms, wherever you get your podcast chat. If you have Amazon Prime, link to your Twitch account. It's called Prime Games. Support the channel by clicking the purple rectangular button below the screen. You can use creator code RocketSock or
Lindsey Ward.
When you buy the guy, you cannot see all the anime and the Chewbacca's and all the Star Wars stuff. Your wallet's going to hurt if you love Star Wars and Fortnite. They have Lego. There's a Lego Battle Pass. There's Chewbacca. There's a bunch of new skins. It's going to be a lot of Star Wars stuff. So if you like it, use creator code RocketSock in the Fortnite item shop or Lindsey Ward. Because hashtag epic partner.
So you can follow me on most of the social medias at Lindsey Ward, LNSWD. You can check me out on Twitch, twitch.tv/Lindsey Ward. You can follow me over on YouTube, youtube.com/@Lindsey Ward. And while it's still available in the United States, because it may in fact go away, you can follow me on TikTok at LindseyWard0. And while you're liking and subscribing and following and doing all the things, you can head over to Matt's channel, MBG Films, youtube.com/MBG1211. And you can follow his channel and like and subscribe and do all the things and tell him we said hi, because Matt's an awesome person. So thank you guys so much for the birthday messages. I appreciate it. It's been a very happy birthday. It's been a great day. I'm looking forward to Backlash on Sunday. I think so is Rock.
On Saturday, yes.
Or excuse me, Saturday, yes. Whatever day it's on, I'm looking forward to it. Let's go with that. I've been drinking. Shocking, I know. But anyway, I hope you guys have a good one. He's Rock, I'm Lindsey. You've been listening to The Rack right here on WildTalkRadio.com. See you later. Bye.